Hello, my name is Matthias Canoa. I'm an applications engineer at ATLANT 3D, and today I'm going to show you some of the samples that we've processed in our lab, which is just behind me. All of this was processed in-house, so in this very lab on our equipment. The wafers that I've brought today are all 4 inches. We've done different studies in terms of different materials that we deposited, different substrates that we used, and I brought some of the more interesting ones here today. A key benefit of ATLANT 3D's direct atomic layer processing technology compared to traditional ALD is the additive manufacturing element. This enables us to make a lot of different thicknesses on the same substrate, which is something that we struggle with traditional methods, because you always have to do one set of thicknesses on one sample, change the sample, do a second one, and so on. So here you can see on this wafer that we've done a very broad range of these thicknesses. And we also did combined this with a sort of repeatability test across the wafer. So we repeated this very long pattern across the entire wafer. And you can see that it's very consistent in, well, just by seeing the colors. And we also observed that it's very consistent in the predicted thicknesses, which means that we are truly in the ALD regime. We know our growth per pass in each kind of recipe. And so that's very useful for testing out new materials, testing out their thicknesses, testing out their growth rates, and then seeing what kind of influence this has on the properties of the material. Another key thing that our technology is very good at compared to traditional microfabrication is making gradients. So on this wafer, you can see we've done a gradient of different thicknesses, progressively getting thicker and thicker. And so basically having kind of like a slope in the profile of the material. This is very difficult to do in traditional microfabrication, or nearly impossible, because you've got nothing. It's always, well, square 2D top down, right? There's nothing, no deposition technology that allows you to make these kind of like slanted depositions. And the fact that traditional microfabrication is a very subtractive process means you always remove layers in very kind of like square manner. So making these gradients and these slanted slopes of material is something quite unique to us, and has a lot of very interesting applications in a lot of different fields, most notably in different kind of like optical elements, optical fields and things like this, which we are exploring a lot of different applications. So both of these were titanium oxide on silicon wafers, but we also have a broad deposition material versatility. So in this wafer there, you can see that we've got some platinum, titanium oxide, and aluminum oxide all processed on the same wafer. So the pattern is the same, but the material is different. And basically, our machines are able to switch between materials quite rapidly. So here we chose to do these three different or separated elements, but you could easily imagine doing your first elements in one material and then overlapping the next ones very rapidly. So that's also something that we're very good at. And on the left here, we've got some platinum depositions. And so basically, this actually takes you through the entire innovation cycle that's possible with ATLANT 3D technology. So starting here, we just start by, well, doing these just straight lines, these benchmark lines that we can identify the right parameters for the deposition of the platinum on the substrate. In this case, that's silicon with silicon oxide on top. And once we found the right regime, so the right parameters, we can deposit on across these different electrodes, so that we can test the electrical properties of the platinum. And once you've found the platinum that you need in terms of electrical properties, then you can just design and print your devices. So in this case, these are interdigitated electrodes that have a wide variety of applications in the field of sensors, biomedical, pharma industry, all sorts of things. It's very common to do these interdigitated things, but you can see also there the differences in the different sizes, and basically take from material development to characterization to ideation and product development very quickly.